Good afternoon, students. Let's start with the next lesson, that is lesson number 4, Kingdom Animalia. There is no deletion in this lesson. All topics are there, all articles are there. Okay? Lesson number 4, Kingdom Animalia. Yes. Kingdom Animalia, by the name itself, it indicates that we are going to study about the animals, okay, present in different phylums, and how they are classified in the phylums, it depends upon their there are certain criterias like grades of organization. This organization may be, or we can say there are levels of organization which can be at the cellular level, cell tissue level, or tissue organ level, etc. Then depending upon the body symmetry, that whether that organism or the animal is asymmetrical, it is radially symmetrical, or it is bilateral symmetrical. Then the third criteria is body cavity, that whether its coelom is present or not. So if it is not present, it is known as acoelomate. If it is present, then but it is not present continuously, then it is known as pseudocoelomate. Pseudo means false. Okay, and if it is there, the coelom is present completely, then it is known as coelomate, right? Then we have also studied about the germ layers. Now, whether the organism is having, that animal is having, an animal is having two layers, that is ectoderm and endoderm only, or all the three layers, germ layers it is having, whether it is, that is ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm. So accordingly, the organisms are classified into diploblastic and triploblastic. Right, then whether the organism is having segments on its body, then that is segmentation. So if it is present, then it is known as segmented organism or animal, and if it is not present, then it is known as unsegmented. Students, in this topic we will be studying about the characteristics of different phylum, example, and how they are classified. First we will study that how they are classified. So what are the criteria I have told you. Now let's see first one, that is body symmetry. Body symmetry means whether the body of an organism can be cut into two equal planes, can be cut at into two equal halves at one particular plane, or whether it can be cut into two equal parts at any plane, or it cannot be cut into two equal parts at all. Okay, so if it cannot be cut, then it is known as, that is, it is known as asymmetrical or no symmetry. Okay, example is sponges, right? And if it can be cut into two equal halves at any plane, that means it is radially symmetrical. An example here is given of polyp, clear? That is coelenterate it is. Then if it can be cut into two equal halves only at one particular plane, then it is known as bilateral symmetry. Okay, so these are the three different types, that is asymmetrical, radially symmetrical, and bilateral symmetrical. You ought to know the meaning or the definition in one line as I've given here, and you have to write at sight at least one example you have to mention in your answer. Then now coelom, whether the coelom is present or not, right? So if it is not present, then it is known as acoelomate. The organism is the acoelomate organism. Example is platyhelminthes. If it is present but in patches, it is present, like you can see over here, this part you can see here, okay, pseudocoelomate, but patches are not shown, so I am showing you over here. See how it is present in patches, this one, right? So this is known as the pseudocoelomate. And if the cavity is complete, okay, body cavity is present, coelom means the presence of body cavity, okay, if it is present completely, then it is known as coelomates. Here an example given is a chordata, that is from annelida up to the chordata, they are all coelomate. So depending upon the type of body cavity, whether the type of means whether the cavity is there or not, it is classified into acoelomate, absence of the cavity, pseudocoelomate, that means it is present in patches or in pouches, and coelomates means the cavity is complete. Next, now the body plan. Body plan means what? That cell is there, organism is there, an organism is there, it is having number of cells. Now whether these cells are present at as a mass okay, or it is present in a particular pattern. So that is we are going to study in the animal body plan. So the first one or the most primitive one is the cell aggregate plan. An example here again is sponges. In this, the body consists of a cluster or aggregation of the cell. Hence, it is known as cell aggregate plan. Okay, which have rudimentary differentiation but are not organized into tissues and organs. So we can simply say sponges do not have tissues or organs well organized. Clear? So this type is known as the cell aggregate plant. Next one is the blind sac plant. Blind sac, that means what? There is, the organism's body is like a sac. Okay, and we know sac means that pota. Okay, it is like a sac, and sac means what? It will have opening only at one end, the other end will be closed. So it is known as blind sac body plant. Okay, and the best example is hydra. You can see over here, this is hydra. See, one side is totally closed and it is open only at one end. So this pattern is known as the blind sac plant. And this is sponges over here. The cells are all aggregated here. Then they are not organized into any of the organs or the tissue properly, differentiated in properly. Then other example is tube within tube. The best example is fish. You see, this is the body. This forms one tube. And inside it's digestive tract completely from mouth up to the anus. You see, again, it is in a tube form only from one end to the another end, isn't it? So this type of plan is known as the tube within tube plan. Okay, an example is the fish. Next, you see the formation of germinal layers. I told you if two germinal layers are present, then it is known as diploblastic. An example is hydra. And if three germ layers are present, like you can see over there, ectoderm is present, endoderm, this inner layer is endoderm. This white one is lumen, students, okay? And the middle one, this orange line, this is the mesoderm. So you can see ectoderm is present, this bluish color. Then mesoderm is present, this orange color. And endoderm is present, this grayish color. And inside this white patch, this is nothing but the lumen. This is triploblastic because all the three layers are present. Example is Ascaris. Remember one example for is that is more than sufficient. Okay, and then here we come down to diploblastic organization. Now here you see this is ectoderm and this is endoderm. We can't find the innermost, that is the orange color layer is not found over here. That is the mesoderm is not seen. It is seen in a form of a non-cellular part, and that is known as the mesoglia. Next, segmentation. Yes, whether the body of the organism is having segments or not. Now you can see in this two diagram, here you can see earthworm is the example, that is annelids. Okay, here, earthworm, see the body is segmented over. You can see segments are present. On the other hand, you can see over here that the body is non-segmented. So Ascaris, lumbricoides. Simply if you remember Ascaris, that is more than sufficient. See, it is not segmented. Okay. So whether the organism is segmented or non-segmented. So depending upon the segmentation also, the animal is classified. This is one of the criteria of it. And if it is segmented, it is known as segmented, it is known as metameric, or it is known as true segmented, or it is also known as metamerism. Okay, example, earthworm. Clear? Yes. Now we will see that whether the organism is having, we have to classify the organisms into chordates and non-chordates. So how do we classify into chordates and non-chordates? Very simple, student. Presence of notochord. You can see this is actually an amphioxus. Okay, later on again, I'll show you this figure. See here, you can see this gray line over here. This is known as the notochord. Now the organisms which are having this notochord are known as chordates. Okay, and those which are not having, we can say chordates, animals with notochord are called chordates, and those without notochord are called as non-chordates, or otherwise chordates are also known as vertebrate, and non-chordates are also known as invertebrates. I hope you understand. Listen carefully, because this whole lesson is classified into two parts. Okay, first of all, three parts. The first basic part is that what are the criteria for classification into different phylums? Okay, that criteria, as I have told you, body plan, body symmetry, etc. Right? Then after that, the remaining part, the all the phylums, they are classified into two parts. Now, depending upon whether the notochord is present or not. If it is present, it is known as chordates or vertebrates. And if it is not present, then it is known as non-chordates or invertebrates. Clear? Now, what is notochord? You see, here you can see this. That's why I kept this diagram over here. This animal, this organism is actually amphioxus. Okay? See here, this gray color line, you can see this is the notochord. Okay? Now, you see here, animals with notochord. These are the various, and by this also you can understand the phylum. See, phylum Pisces, okay, then amphibians, clear, reptilians, aves, and the mammals. They all are having the notochord, clear. Now, these are the organisms who do not have the notochord. They are referred as invertebrates. You can see these different categories of them. Okay, one example is given from all the phylums. Let's study this one by one in detail. Here. Now, criteria for animal classification. This whatever I have told, that is summarized over here. Okay, number of germ layers, two or three, diploblastic and triploblastic. With example, it is given. Then animal body plan, cell body symmetry. Then whether the coelom is present or not. What is coelom? It is the body cavity. Okay, then whether the body is segmented or not. And whether the body has got some support or not. That is, whether it is having some skeleton part. If it is present outside the body, for example, any insect, then it is known as exoskeleton. Example is insects, any insect. Okay, and if it is present inside the body also and outside the body also, then it is, that means endoskeleton and exoskeleton, both are present, then it is, examples are vertebrates. Okay, so this is the criteria. This is just a summary with examples. Next. Now here, all the phylums, they are classified, I told you just now, non-chordate or invertebrates and chordates with vertebrates and or vertebrates. Okay. Now you see here, the different phylums are given right from Porifera up to the mammalian. Okay. Pisces, mammalian, that is chordates are given over here. So these are all non-chordates, that is up to phylum Hemichordata. An example of each is given over here. This is just a summary like, okay, and then this belongs to the, this comes the chordate, and examples are given over here. Yeah. Now we will study the first one, that is the phylum Porifera. Now I told you all the phylums, we in general, we will be studying about all the important categories, characteristics. Okay, and examples here in the bracket, I have given example. So you ought to remember the example and you have to remember these categories. Now in this characteristic, in characteristics, what we are going to write, that where the species is present, then whether it is having coelom or not, then what is the body pattern, body plan pattern, what is it, whether it is having skeleton, or it is having both endo and exoskeleton it is having. So these are the different criteria that we are going to study taking each phylum. Then their mode of reproduction, that whether it is asexual, sexual reproduction it is. Okay. So these all things we are going to study in different categories. Now for phylum Porifera, example is Cycon or Spongilla, right? And Spongilla. The word Porifera refers to the pores bearers. Okay. Pore bearer means these organisms, they are having minute openings or apertures on their body. Okay. So, and these openings are known as osculum or ostia, singular and plural. Okay. So these organisms are those organisms which are having apertures or openings or pores, or otherwise scientifically it is known as ostia or osculum, on their body are coming under Porifera. An example is Cycon and Spongilla. Here I have given only two examples. Then they are the lowest multicellular animals belonging to the kingdom Animalia. Poriferans have a spongy appearance, therefore they are called sponges. Then loosely organized cells are there. Now see all the characteristics, it is written in brief, okay, just point-wise hint it is given in this. You can write in the exam also this way and score full marks, okay? See, they are mostly marine. Then they are found in fresh water also. They are asymmetrical, body is cylindrical. There is no organs in their body. That means they are not differentiated. Okay. Then cell aggregation plan, that is. Then shows cellular grade of organization. Then has central cavity called spongocoel or atrium, which opens to outside by osculum. Osculum is the opening or the mouth of it. Okay. Nutrition is holozoic, have neurosensory cells, but no specific nervous system is there. I told you this, but tissues are not organized. Okay, no organ is organized here in case of sponges. So nervous system in the organism is sensitive, but there is no particular nervous system, no specific nervous system present. Then they have power of regeneration, can regenerate their lost part. That means what if any part of it is cut, it can again develop, it can again regenerate. For example, if you know lizard tail, if you cut, then what happens? It again comes after a few days or weeks. Okay, so that is known as regeneration. Then exchange of respiratory gases and nitrogen waste occurs by process of diffusion because there is no system. Okay, and the body is porous. So through the body surface, it happens by the process of diffusion. They are attached to the substratum. That means they are anchored to particular part, maybe to the rock, maybe to the logs, that is wooden logs or anything, that is known as the substratum. Okay, they have ability, understand this term, student, because in all we will be having one of the terms like this. Okay, they have ability to absorb and withhold fluids. Withhold fluid means they can retain fluid in the body for some time. Then water is circulated in the body through canal system. Skeleton is spicules, minute spikes are present. Okay, spines we can say. Then spongy fibers are also present. So they form the skeleton. Then reproduction, they are hermaphrodite. What is hermaphrodite? The meaning of hermaphrodite is that both male and female reproductive organs are present in the or present on the same body. Okay, there is one animal, right? And that is having both male reproductive organ also and female reproductive organ also. And that is known as the, and such organisms are known as hermaphrodite. One more example I will give you, that is an earthworm. Okay, hydra. These are all the organisms which are hermaphrodite. Clear? Reproduces asexually by fragmentation and budding. Sexually by gametes. The development is indirect. That is presence of larval stage is there in between. Indirect means directly it is not getting developed into the adult form. In fact, there is one stage known as the larval stage. And the cleavage is holoblastic. Holoblastic means the egg is cut. Cleavage means the cutting or the dividing of the egg, okay, or the zygote, which will be forming number of cells from one cell to two cell, then four cells, like this, okay, by the process of mitosis. Clear? So this cleavage is holoblastic. Holoblastic means the complete egg or the complete zygote is cut into two equal parts. Clear? So that is known as the holoblastic. Now you see here, this is zygote, this is spongula. Clear? These are the examples for porifera. Then next you see phylum. One minute, student. Yeah. Something is right. Now here we will be studying about this phylum, Cnidaria. Their habitat is aquatic. Okay, tissue level organization is there. Mouth is enclosed by thin and short tentacles like cnidoblast or cnidocytes. Cytes means the cells, okay? Stinging capsule on tentacles are present. Stinging means smelling, okay? Then used for, which is because of this smell, no organism come close to it. So it is used as a defensive structure. And also these capsules or the tentacles, they help in the anchorage. That is the anchoring to that substratum, clear? Then they are diploblastic. That means what? Two layers are present, ecto and endoderm. Then they are readily symmetric. They are having intra and extracellular digestion process. They are having absence of nervous and circulatory system is seen. Okay. Then excretion and respiration through simple diffusion. Then they have coral, like corals are the skeleton part here. Then made up of calcium carbonate. That means the skeleton is made up of calcium carbonate. Okay. Then reproduction is asexual by budding. Sexual mode is seen in few coelenterates. So usually the reproduction is by asexual method, and the method in asexual is budding. It can be fragmentation or other ways also, but here it is seen in form of budding. One example of budding I will give you, yeast students. Okay, but here we are studying about the cnidaria. Clear? Then exhibit two basic forms are there. One is the sessile type, that is hydra, and that is in the form of polyp. Okay, and other one is umbrella like, and that body form is the medusa. Okay, so polyp is sessile, example hydra, then umbrella like and is the medusa. The name is medusa, and the example is jellyfish, right? And then it shows alternation of generation, that is metagenesis. Alternation of generation is known as metagenesis, where polyp forms medusa asexually and medusa forms polyp sexually. Like we have studied in kingdom plantae, sporophytic and gametophytic, they alternate, okay, in the life cycle of the organism, of say example fern or moss, isn't it? Now the same way here also there is alternation of generation. The process is known as metagenesis. And here we have, there is two basic forms are there. One is sessile or the cylindrical like, known as hydra, and other one is medusa, that is umbrella shape. Example is Obelia or the jellyfish. See, these are the type of cnidarians. Sea anemone is there, see, umbrella like. Hydras are there, cylindrical, right? Jellyfish is there, see, again, medusa type, right? This is the sea corals here present. Calcium carbonate is present in this corals. Now, phylum Ctenophora, okay? Commonly called as comb jellies or sea walnuts. They are free swimming, marine, solitary means single. Marine means they're present in seawater, okay? Then pelagic animals are there, then body is transparent, gelatinous, pear-shaped, pear is a fruit, okay? Pear, we call it in Marathi. Then cylindrical, flat, ribbon-shaped, jelly-like, soft body. So these are the characteristics. They are radially symmetrical. Then tissue level organization is seen. Now see how it is evolving. Okay. Then body bears 8 rows of ciliated comb plates for locomotion. They are acoelomate. That means they do not have the body cavity. They are triploblastic. That means they are having 3 germ layers. Right. Then we can see 3 germ layers means outer epidermis is there, middle jelly like mesoglia with scattered cells and muscle. That is the beginning of 3 germ layers it is. Right, then it lacks nematocyst. What is nematocyst? These are the cells for defense. Okay, nematocysts, they do not have the defensive cells. Okay, and the defensive cells are known as nematocyst. And what are nematocysts? These are the specialized cells for self defense. Yeah, then they have digestive system, which consists of mouth, stomedium, the stomach, then complex gastrovascular canals and 2 aboral and anal pores. Aboral means end way from mouth. Okay, end away from mouth. So 2 openings, 1 mouth and other one will be the anal pores. Then skeleton is absent. Okay, earlier only we told jellyfish, they're soft body. So no skeleton is seen here. Circulatory, respiratory and excretory organs, these are all absent. Then nervous system is diffuse type, that means very primitive type. Then aboral and end bears a sensory organ called statocyst. It does not have the specialized cells for self defense, but it is having the sensory organ known as statocyst. Okay, and this static, understand? We are physics students. You know the meaning of it, that is equilibrium. So the statocyst, what is its function? To maintain the equilibrium, body equilibrium. Then they are hermaphrodite, means what? Both the sex organs are present in the same animal, same organism. And such hermaphrodite organisms are known as monoecious. And if they are present separately, then it is known as dioecious. Students, you are familiar with all these terms I had been telling in the first, second and third lesson. So please try to recall and understand what I am telling you here. Okay. Then it reproduces sexually. fertilization is external, that means it is not in the body. Then, and indirect development is seen. Indirect development, what? That larval stage will be there. Okay. Regeneration is there. That means what? The lost part can be again generated by the organism. Then pedogenesis is there. That means pedogenesis means what? The reproduction by sexually mature larvae. Okay. That means larval stage is there, student, before it goes into or get metamorphosed into the adult form. The chances are there that this mature larvae can also reproduce. Okay, this is known as pedogenesis. This is a new term for you students, right? What is pedogenesis? Genesis means to generate, to form. Okay, reproduction by sexually matured larvae is known as pedogenesis. Okay, usually without fertilization, it is. This process is common in case of Ctenophoras. Clear? That is sea walnuts, sperm jellies, etc. Then bioluminescence, that means they can emit light, they can give out the light, okay, is well developed. This part is bioluminescence is well developed in these organisms. Now see here, phylum Ctenophora, sperm jellies or sea walnuts. See here, it can illuminate. This is bioluminescence. Okay, it can emit light. Next comes phylum Platyhelminthes. That is, their platy means what? Flat. And helminth what? Worm. So flatworms. Okay. And how they are flattened? They are flattened dorso-ventrally. They are triploblastic. That means three germ layers are present. Acoelomates. That means no body cavity. Bilateral symmetrical. That means they can be cut into two equal halves. On two equal halves they can be cut. And at only one plane it can be cut. Endoparasitic it is. That is what? It is present inside the digestive tract of the organism. Then organ level of organization is seen. Presence of hooks are there and suckers are there. They are non-segmented. That means they do not have segment in the on the body surface. Then they are soft, covering with or without cilia. So they cilia may or may not be present. Okay. No digestive tract is seen over here. Mouth, it has mouth, but devoid of anus. That means only one opening. Absence of circulatory system, respires by simple diffusion through the body surface. Animals have flame cells. They are they are excretory. Flame cells means they are excretory cells. Okay. And this flame cell, we can call it as protonephridia also. Okay. Which is helpful for excretion and osmoregulation. Right. They are hermaphrodite. Now, I'll not tell you the meaning of hermaphrodite. You should remember that sexes are not separate. They are present. Both male and female reproductive organs are present in the same organism. That is hermaphrodite. And they are otherwise also known as monoecious. Okay. The nervous system comprises of the brain and two longitudinal nerve cords, which are arranged in a ladder-like fashion. Then reproduction, it is sexually by fusion of gametes, asexually by regeneration, and fertilization is internal. In the last class, we saw that last phylum, what did we see? That fertilization is external. Here, fertilization is internal, that is inside the body of the organism, and development is through many larval stages. That means development is not direct. Now you can see here, Platyhelminthes, right? You can see this liver fluke. This is tapeworm. This is planaria. These are the examples of Platyhelminthes. I told you they have hooks. See here, by which they can anchor themselves to the particular part where they are present. Here, see, this is the detailed part of the head region of the tapeworm over here. They have got suckers to which again they can attach and they can absorb certain material. Hence the name suckers. Now, Aeschylomyces. The phylum is Aeschylomyces, and commonly they are also known as the roundworms. Okay. They are present in the soil. Habitat means where they are present. They are present or they are found in the soil. They are also seen in the fresh water and also as a parasite on plants, animals, and even in the humans. Okay. Ascaris, this is the example, Ascaris, and it is endoparasite in the human intestine. Now, triploblastic, you know the meaning. Three-layered, bilateral symmetrical, you know the meaning, that it can be cut into two equal halves at one and only one plane. Then pseudocoelomate, that means the coelom, that is the body cavity, is present in pouches or in patches. Okay, it is having tube within tube body plan. I told you example fish I gave you there, isn't it, in the introduction. Then body is non-segmented, it is long, it is slender, it is thread-like and tapers at the end. Then organ system level of body organization is seen. Then respiratory system is absent, and the gaseous, then if respiratory system is absent, then how will it breathe or how will it exchange the gas? It is occurring through the body surface. Then there is no skeletal system. Instead, the pseudocoelomic fluid act as a hydroskeleton. Now, what is, I told you about exoskeleton and endoskeleton. Exoskeleton means what? Which is present on the outside the body. Okay. And endo means which is present inside the body. So then what is hydroskeleton? Hydro indicates for water. So this mesoglia, that is the pseudocoelomic fluid, is present. That only works as skeleton. Okay. That means it gives the turgidness or it gives a shape to the particular organism. So that is referred as a hydroskeleton, right? Then digestive system is complete, with mouth and anus at opposite ends. Yeah. Then nervous system comprises of nerve ring and the nerve cord. Excretion takes place by canals or gland cells, and elimination through the excretory pores. Then reproduction, they are dioecious. What is dioecious? Sexes are separate. That means what? The male sex organ is present in one organism and the female sex organ is present in the female organism. So two sexes are there, male and female. Yeah? Then fertilization is internal and development is direct. Direct development means what? There is no larval stage in it. Now, you see, these are non-segmented worms, okay? Nementhelminthes, or they're also known as Ascalminthes, right? Example, Ascaris, Vutria, then Entibrobius, and then Rhabditis. Any one or two examples, if you remember, that is more than sufficient for you to write the answer. Now, this phylum is phylum Annelida, okay? Now, Annelida comes from the word annulus. Annulus means what? The ring, okay? If you remember in 11th, I have taught 11th only, this is okay. Fine. Annulus means a ring-like, right? And therefore, they are also known as the ringworms. See, students, if they are flat, then they are known as flatworms. Worms which are having ring-like structure that is on the body, that is known as the ringworm. Now, they are aquatic. They may be terrestrial. They are free-living, or they may be parasite. They are triploblastic, three-layered, bilateral, only at one particular plane. They can be divided into two halves. Then they are in metamerically segmented. What is segmented? In commonly, in English word, we use it as segmentation. Okay, and in biology, you can use the word metamerism. That is a correct word. Okay, metamerism. Or we simply join the two words and we say metamerically segmented. Clear? Then coelomate, that means it is having proper body cavity. Coelom is present. Then it possesses longitudinal and circular muscles which help in locomotion. How it helps in locomotion? By its act. What is the characteristic of muscle, student? To contract and to relax. Because of this, they are able to move forward, or they can show, or they can carry on the process of locomotion. Clear? They exhibit organ system level of organization, that means certain organs are present. Then they respire through their body surface. Then nephridia, again, they are the excretory structures. Okay, nephridia help in osmoregulation and excretion. Then well-developed circulatory system is present, and circulatory systems are of two types, open type and closed type. So here it is having closed type, and digestive system is there. Then body contains hemoglobin, which gives them red color. Okay, and presence of hemoglobin indicates that it can carry the oxygen to the respiratory structures, to the respiratory organ. Then locomotive structures like setae, these are small processes, okay, which are present in this example is earthworm, which helps them to locomote. And also the setae, they help to capture the female to capture the other earthworm for the process of copulation. Students, although earthworm is a hermaphrodite organism, but because of the difference in the time of their maturity of the reproductive structures, okay, or the gametes, right? Because of that, they have to take, they have to undergo the process of copulation with other earthworm. Clear? So that is known as the and setae helps in capturing the other earthworm at the time of copulation. Then parapodia, example nereus is there, and suckers are present. That is leech is there, suckers are present. So locomotory organs like setae, example earthworm, parapodia, podia indicates for the legs, example nereus, and suckers are present in case of leech. Okay, nervous system consists of nerve ring and ganglionated nerve cord. Then reproduction, it is mostly hermaphrodites and few are dioecious. That means sexes are separate there. Then reproduction is sexual. Now here you can see, these are the parapodias. These legs you can see over here. This is the sucker. In case of the hirudinaria, that means the leech, the zoological name is hirudinaria, and this is the earthworm. Its body is segmented and it is having small protrusions, that is known as the setae, which is helping in locomotion as well as to capture or to hold the other earthworm for the process of copulation. Okay, so these are the three different examples of it, of annelids. Now here comes the next this thing, arthropoda. It is next phylum, that is arthropoda. Okay, examples are given over here. You see, that is like mosquitoes are there, house flies are there, crab is there. You see here, arthropoda example, prawn, spider, butterfly, house fly, centipede, scorpion, cockroach, crab. These all come under the class arthropoda or phylum arthropoda, right? They are the animals with jointed appendages. Arthros means joint. Okay, see, if you remember a disease known as arthritis. Okay, this arthritis means what? The joint pains are there. Okay, this I'm just correlating for you. Arthros means what? Arthritis means what? Like that. Okay, so arthros, that is arthropoda. Arthros means the joint, podas means the leg, right? It is the largest phylum of kingdom Animalia. They are omnipresent. Omnipresent means they are present everywhere. Solitary means they can be present singly or they can be present in colonies, or that is in the group. They're free living, organ system level of body organization, bilateral, symmetrical they are. They are segmented, they are coelomate, they are chitinous, exoskeleton they are having. Then body is divided into head, thorax and abdomen. Then open type of circulatory system is present. That means blood is moving in the cavity itself, in between the organs. There is no particular channel or the blood vessels present, that is open type. And if it is present, then it is known as the closed type. Okay, respiratory organs are present in the form of gills or book lungs or tracheal system. Nervous system is formed by nerve ring and double ventral ganglionated nerve cord. That means double, which is ventral in position, and it is having ganglions. What? Nerve cord. Okay. Sense organs are antennae. Eye may be simple or it can be compound. Then statocyte, that means what? It is a balancing organ is present. Then they're having well-developed mouth parts. Then excretion by green glands. Okay. Then malpighian tubules or coxal glands. So these are the excretory structures present in the body. Reproduction, they are dioecious. Then they are oviparous. Oviparous means internal fertilization. They show sexual dimorphism. That means male and female species differ in external appearance. Okay, from externally we can find out that whether it is male or female. So that is known as dimorphism. Di means two. Okay, two sexes, right? And morphism means morphology. So externally we can see differentiate between the male and the female organism. Then develop may be direct or indirect. It can be. Some arthropods are economically important. For example, honeybees and silkworm. It gives us honey, it gives us silk. That some are vectors like mosquito, which causes malaria, housefly, which can cause TB, tuberculosis also. Okay, matlab, if they become the vectors, they are not the actual, they carry, that is a vectors. Okay, then some are aquatic animal, aquatic like crab, prawn, lobster, etc. You can see this, I have shown you this already, this chart, I have shown you. Then comes the next one, that is the second largest phylum, and that is the phylum Mollusca. Okay, they are again, they can be terrestrial or they can be aquatic or marshy. They are free living, they are sedentary, their nervous system consists of number of paired ganglia and nerves. They have tentacles, they have eyes, they have balancing organs, that is statocysts, as the and statocysts are also, they also act as a sensory organs also. Their reproduction is oviparous. They are, it can be direct or indirect development. Then in this sexes are separate. Okay, they are the sources of jewelry as well as food. So they can be either, they are edible, some of them they are edible also, or their parts, they can be, it can, it is used to make jewelries. Then natural pearls, that is like unio, freshwater mussel. Okay, they, we get pearl out of it, moti, that is. Okay, are formed within the mollusk. The bivalve mollusk, that is freshwater mussel. Bivalve means freshwater, but they're having two valves. And when we open that, we see that there is a pearl in that. Okay, they are used as bio indicators in the marine and freshwater environment. See, these are the different examples of mollusca. Then echinodermata, they are exclusively marine. That means that only present in marine, that is in the seawater. They are found in sea depth as well as in the intertidal zones, right? Then the organisms, they are having spiny skin. They are triploblastic, they are coelomate, they are radially symmetrical. Their excretory system is absent. There is no head, mouth and ventral side and anus on the dorsal side. Then they have water vascular system, helps in locomotion, which helps in locomotion. They help in capturing food and for respiration also. This vascular system helps in locomotion, it helps in capturing the food and also helps for respiration. Then reproduction, it is sexually by gamete fusion, then asexually through regeneration. Then fertilization is external, indirect development with free swimming larva only. Then they possess the power of regeneration. See, these are the examples of echinodermata. Example, starfish. Now when we see this, we can say that it is radially symmetry. Sea urchin, radially symmetry. Okay, sea cucumber. When we cut this, we can cut it at any plane, we get equal halves. Then sea lily here. These are the different examples of echinodermata. Okay, now phylum hemichordata. Hemi means half. Chorda means presence of chord. So half chordate. Half chordate it is. Now in the beginning I told you which do not have, they are known as non-chordate. Which have, that is known as chordate. And which is having only half chord, that is known as hemichordata. So we say that hemichordata is the link, okay? It is the connecting link between non-chordata and chordata. Clear? Worms are like, worms like marine animals, usually at the bottom of the sea in burrows. They can be single or they can be colonial. They are free living. Then body is soft. It is fragile. That can, it can be broken up. Okay. Then vermiform, unsegmented. They are bilateral, symmetrical, and triploblastic. The body is divisible into proboscis, collar, and trunk. Body wall with a single layered epidermis with mucous gland is there. No dermis is present. Then alimentary canal is straight, complete, or U-shaped tube it is. Then pharyngeal gills for respiration. Right. Gills opened by gill slits. Simple, open and well-developed circulatory system they have got, open type of circulatory system, right? Then excretion is by a single glomerulus situated in the proboscis. Then primitive type nervous system and subepidermal nerve plexus are seen. Then reproduction, all the characteristics are present in this point. For all the phylums, I have given this way so that it is easy for you to learn and understand, okay? Reproduction, mainly sexual, sexes are separate. Gonads, one to several pairs, gonads are present. Gonads mean that sexual organ, testes or the ovary, they are present one to several pairs. Then fertilization is external, development is indirect by free swimming larvae. This was about the phylum Hermichordata. And you can see the best example, Balanoglossus, and sacoglossus. Right? See here, this is the proboscis. Proboscis. Right? Something I wanted to tell you here. Just a second. Okay. Yeah. Examples I have given you. Fine. This is balanoglossus and sacoglossus. I will stop here. This is all about the non-chordates. Okay. Up to from porifera up to hemichordata. I have given all the characters. I have given you the example and everything. Go through it properly, student. And if you don't understand, you can ask me through my personal WhatsApp. Okay. I stop here. Thank you so much.